We shall learn how to create a database using SQL Server Compact. So our objective is to learn how to create a database because we generally need it in our projects, and let us now see. SQL Server Compact is a database which is very small in size. It can hold relatively large amounts of data with a very small file size. There are certain disadvantages. You cannot have stored procedures in this. I see this is the only one disadvantage. Otherwise, it is very easy to deploy. Just copy the file to your project. If you want to upload it to a web server, you have to just copy the SQL Server Compact file to the web server. So backups are easy. You can change it anytime. You don't have to go through the process of writing complex queries. I have always found it handy in my projects, and let us see how to create a database using SQL Server Compact. Right click, so this is a basic MVC app that we have created. It doesn't have any controllers, models. So right click here and click add new item. In the left pane you can see Visual C Sharp, choose data. And in this list you will find SQL Server Compact 4.0 or maybe 3.5 depending on the version you have. And you can make a selection here. So give it any name. We are giving it name DB Registration. And click Add. It says you are attempting to add a special type SDF. The extension is SDF. To an ASP.NET website, in general to use this type of item, you should place it in app underscore data. Yes, we'll place it in app underscore data because it is secure also. Click yes. Clicking yes will immediately add certain references for the DLLs. And then if you see your app underscore data, you will find the SDF file. This SDF file along with these DLLs can be copied. These DLLs can be copied to your bin folder, and this database can be copied to app underscore data, and the entire thing starts working. Now how do we add tables? This is under Solution Explorer. Visual Studio automatically picks up any database file under app underscore data and will show you it under Database Explorer. Click data connections and you will find your database appearing here. Click this one, tables and replication subscriptions. So these are a bit of off the line topics. We are worried about tables right now. Right click, create table. You will find this type of a view. It might not be appearing completely on this window, but it will be whatever is visible, you can make it out. So I'll give it a name TBL Registration. So I've given the name Registration and just click on this column once, and I'll give it name ID. Here I can choose the data type. I choose it to be int. So data types appropriate for SQL are available here. Allow nulls, yes. Unique, no. Actually I want it to be a primary key, so I'll click on yes. The moment I click yes here, this automatically turns to no, and this automatically turns to no. So unique is actually an index that can be made against a column, as you already know from your SQL. Since it is already a primary key, the index will always be there automatically. No separate index needs to be added. We might also want this index to be ID to be auto numbered, so that it increments automatically. When you add the first record, it has a value 1. When next record is added, it automatically increments to 2. So for that, we always have a possibility of adding an identity. Click true and you automatically see identity increment. So it will increment by 1. So 1, 2, 3, seed, that is the starting value. So next column. Next column, I'll add email ID. And I can set it and where care. Length, I'll keep it 50. Allow nulls. No, we won't allow nulls. It ideally, email can be a primary key, and it should be. But since we are demonstrating a particular example here, we wanted to show first of all an ID, auto number ID. So we are not making it primary key, but you should make it primary key. We'll index it to unique. Then date of birth. We can pick some date time we are from here. So it is, so you can pick this one, it's date time. Allow nulls, no, unique primary key. And if you want to give it a default value to anything, normally we can write it get date. This function can be called here if you want to give it the current date. Just for demonstration, generally date of birth won't be the current date. But if you want to give it to a current date, then you can write get date here. This function will automatically add its default value to current date. Then we can write qualification. I'm not being very uniform here. Qualification can be put equal to NCAR 1. Allow nulls, no, unique primary key. So why are we keeping it to 1? Because we plan to maintain another table of qualifications where details are there and code for each qualification. So we can say BE will have a code of small b or whatever. So it will be ultimately a character. MTech can be a code C. So qualification will be an NCAR. That is, it will be one single character. So it will we'll have to create another table for qualification, and this will be a foreign key from there. So that's why I've set it NCAR, and I can give it a default value of, let us say I'll give it a default value of B, for we'll take it BTech later on. We'll specify that this represents BTech. Then after qualification, we can come to nationality. On the same lines, optimization aid is to keep it 1 and keep it no and give it a default value of I. So it will be Indian. Nationality. Qualification, I think I have to put it in, most probably should be double quote, as I'll see later. At the time of saving, it will tell us if something is wrong. ID, email, date of birth, qualification, nationality. Then we also plan to store the picture. There is a column of blob type here, but it's not big, binary could be there. Certain But it's generally not recommended to store pictures or videos into this because it becomes a little bit inefficient. We can always store pictures based on ID field or email ID. So no column needs to be made for the email. So this almost includes all the types: int, enquirechar, data type, enquirechar. The commonly used types I've included. After you have done it, you can click on OK. So everything was accepted and we have a table called TBL registration. Let us add a table for qualification also. Create table TBL qualifications base. This table is going to contain a list of qualifications, and since it is going to be a parent table, that is, it is going to supply a foreign key into the main table, I generally add base to this so that it looks like it is easy to understand that values are probably coming from here into that table. So this is the parent table and that is the child table. Now I can write call name, column name. I can call qualification code, keep it enquirechar, keep it 1, allow nulls, no, primary key, yes. So it's the primary key here. And I can write here description and put it enquirechar 50, okay, allow nulls, no, primary key, no, and then we can click okay. Similarly, let us add a table for although it's not required, for nationalities I was thinking of adding a table. But nationalities either Indian or non-Indian, so this can, the table is not required for this. Now let us proceed to add relationships between them. Right click, right click on TBL registration, click on table properties. And here you have add relations. We can give any name, so I'll give it qualifications FK. Update action can be set to cascade. This means if anything changes in the parent table, the value will be changed everywhere in the child table. Delete cascade, if you delete something from the parent table, then the corresponding records from the table, child table, will also be deleted. Be careful with this rule especially. So it's only for demonstration that I am adding a relation, but generally, personally, I don't add because it generally corrupts the data unnecessarily. But if you are learning, then it is possible to do it this way. Then primary table is qualifications base, the parent table, foreign key table is this, primary key table is, column is qualification code, you see, and here you have a corresponding qualification. There care matter, match, and we'll click add columns. It comes in the list below and then we can click OK and come out. And if you, and when you have clicked that OK, you will find constraint successfully added. Click OK to commit the transaction. We'll click OK and it is added. So finally close the dialog. So the relation is preserved under indexes. Then there you added a unique relation in the beginning, so that is already there, unique index. This is the primary key, but that relation is stored somewhere internally. Probably it is stored with the primary key table. So it has a primary key const, it's also primary key, so it is probably stored internally by the database then. Now let us add some data to it. TBL qualification, right click, show table data. So we'll add qualification code B, we should add first because we already created a default value there. B tech. Enter. Enter. When you press enter, it will commit. Then I can write M for M tech. Click enter and it will be committed. So B tech, M tech, we can write A for BCA. Okay. Similarly, let us add some data to show table. You don't need to save anything, it's already committed. The moment you click enter, it gets committed. Close it. Let us add some dummy data to our TBL registration. IDs, look, it's dull. You can't type into it because it is auto numbered. Email ID, I'll type support@hovan.in. Date of birth, I'll leave it to show you that it actually gets its default value. Qualification, we are leaving it because it will automatically pick the default value. Nationality is already defaulted I. And when I click enter, a red sign appears here. So what I have to do is I have to do commit on this. So this is an arrow. Click. And it automatically adds all the defaults. This is the current date time. Qualification I. So this is how we can create a database and add constraints to it. And where does it go? It is already stored under app_data. So thanks.